So I want to take a minute to talk about the importance of datum flag placement. So this is just a quick sample drawing that I whipped together based on one of the examples from the ASME Y14.5 standard. And if we look at the three main datums here, A, B, and C, you notice I highlighted A in green, and then B and C are highlighted in blue. And in A, you'll notice that there's an offset between the datum flag and the linear dimension, the 12.7 dimension. Whereas on B and C, the datum flag is actually aligned with the linear dimension. And I want to talk about why that is. And I've had some people tell me it doesn't matter. The truth is, yes, it completely changes what we think the datum is. So in the case of datum A, the way we have it on our drawing right now, we're only looking at that flat surface. Whereas datum B, because we have it in line with the dimension, it's actually pointing to the axis of that boss. And then datum C, it's actually the center plane that bisects that slot feature on the cap. So what if datum A was aligned with the dimension arrows instead of being offset? If we did that, like shown in the drawing on the left-hand side here, datum A, you can see the flag is in line with the 12.7 dimension now. There is no offset. That actually means that datum A is the center plane that bisects the thickness of that cap instead of just the mating surface. And the reason why that's important, because elsewhere in the GD&T standard, they show you a nice little application for this cover, this cap, and how it mates up against the body. And so we really want that inner surface to be our datum, not the center of the surface, if that makes sense. And that's actually important because how you define your datums and how the datums are understood by the people making the part is all part of getting rid of that ambiguity. So the placement of your datum flag is really important. As a side note, there's also a place that's called out on the standard where you definitely do not want to place your datum. And I've actually been guilty of this. I'd get a drawing that's a little bit too cluttered, and I don't want to try and jam a datum flag in there too. So I've thrown the datum flag on the right-hand side here. You can see where the datum flag is actually on the axis of the screw boss, or of the round boss on this cap. And it's very explicit in the standard. It's quoted here at the bottom. The datum feature symbol shall not be applied to center lines, center planes, or axes. It needs to be something that's actually measurable by the metrology department. So it can't be something that's derived or calculated. It has to be based right off that that actual diameter of that boss. So remember, when the datum flag aligns with the dimension, then the datum is understood as the center line or center plane of that dimension. Otherwise, the flag has to be offset from the size dimension. So hopefully you guys find this useful and you can avoid some of the mistakes I've made in the past. And remember, do not place the datum flag on the actual center line or on the actual center plane marks on your drawings. It may look prettier, but it's not allowed in the standard. And you lose credibility when you do stuff like that. People know that you don't really know the standard that well. So hopefully you guys find this helpful and you're able to avoid some of the pitfalls I've made. We'll talk to you later.